Now, question number 4. Three coins are tossed simultaneously 200 times. This is the total times we have tossed three coins. Okay? With the following frequencies of different outcomes. So, out of 200 times, how many times three heads appeared on the top of the coin? That is 23 times. Dear students, if you toss a coin, definitely you will get either a head or tail. So we have tossed 200 times. So we got three heads. How many times? 23 times. Two heads kitni baar aaye? 72 times. One head? 77 times. And no head? No head means all the three coins have tail. Okay? For three tails or no head, the outcomes are 28. One head, agar three coins hain beta, on one coin, one head is there, what is the face of the other two coins? That means two tails. Two heads, on three coins, two heads are there, then the third coin will face, yes, one tail. Three heads means all the three coins have three heads, no tail is there. So with the information of heads, we also get the information of tails, right? So if the three coins are simultaneously tossed again, compute the probability of two heads. We have to find out the probability of two heads. Hame two heads ke nikalni hai. So dear students, very first of all, we will write the total number of times the three coins tossed. Three coins tossed 200 times. This is the total and this is what you have to write in the denominator. Now in the table, three heads. All the three coins have got three heads for 23 times. Let us write all the outcomes. It is given that two heads appeared for 72 times. Dear students, two heads, teen coin hai. Teen coin ke do faces are facing two heads. Then the third coin must have one tail. Do coins par to kya a gaya? Head. Then what about the third coin? That means third coin is having tail. Three heads, that means all the three coins have faced head. Aapne toss kiya aur teeno coins par head a gaya. Outcomes of one head. One head appeared for 77 times. Means we have three coins. When we have tossed 77 times, we got one head. On one coin, it is head. What about the other two coins? That means they are facing tail. Then outcomes of no head. Dear students, that means on the three coins, no head is there. No head means all the three coins are facing tail. Right? In this way. So for no head, the number of outcomes given to us in the table are 28. Right? So dear students, along with the heads, we are getting the information about the tail also. Just look at here. Along with the information of heads, we are getting the tail information. If I'll ask you how many times no tail appears. So no tail means all the three heads, that is 23. How many times one tail appear? One tail means on two coins, two heads, that is 72. Two for two tails, one head, 77 times. For three tails means no head. All the three coins are facing no head. That means all three are facing with the tail. That is 28. So now it's time to write down the probability. Now probability of two heads. How many times two heads appeared? 72. So we'll write 72 in the numerator. And total number of times tossed, 200. So what is the answer? We'll write 72 divided by 200. Now, in only this part has been asked in the question, but I am explaining you few more examples related to this question, like probability of three heads. So just look at the table. Probability of the number of outcomes in the favor of three heads are 23. So 23 divided by total, we'll write 23 divided by 200. Similarly, dear students, about one tail. One tail, now head information is given to us. The information is not about the tail. But along with the heads, we are getting the information of one tail also. one tail. When do we get one tail? When the two coins are facing two heads. Two heads means one tail. That means we'll use 72 divided by total. 72 divided by total. Now, one more example, probability of getting three tails. Dear students, three tails means no head is there. No head means three tails. So how many outcomes are there? 28 divided by total 200. So we'll write 28 divided by total. So in this way, dear students, many more questions can be asked from this question. So do not only stuck to the given question. You must understand the concept of remaining parts also. So try some more, like two tails, two heads, zero head, no head, many more questions can be asked from this.